Oh yes, the updates on Deadpool 3 are coming at us fast and furious. Just without Vin Diesel and The Rock bench-pressing rockets, or whatever the hell happened in that movie. Anyways, let's talk about Deadpool 3 and how Marvel Studios is going to let Ryan Reynolds dictate some of the terms? Interesting. I don't think it needs to be stated, but Deadpool 3 is still years away. It's going to be years until we get official news on castings and all that. But what has been made available since the initial update by Deadline is the fact that new reports have now surfaced online and been confirmed by others. When it comes to Deadpool 3 being a Marvel Studios film, there is one thing that has to happen. Marvel Studios president Kevin Feige has to be hands-on. And if he's hands-on, it's a Marvel Studios property set in the MCU. And he also calls all the shots and nobody else. When it comes to the Deadpool property that was over at Fox, things went pretty much all to Ryan Reynolds when it came to the second movie, which is why they decided to make the movie that they did, and why Tim Miller, the director of Deadpool 1, was let go. And from previous reports, it was made very clear, I think, by everybody involved, the fact that Ryan Reynolds wanted more creative freedom on Deadpool, but Kevin Feige was not going to just let him do the things he wanted to and make the exact movie he wanted to, because it has to fit within the MCU confines, and you can't break that mold. So the brand new report that was updated, and then Deadline also has it on there, is the fact that Ryan Reynolds and Kevin Feige will be working hand in hand on the upcoming Deadpool sequel. Now, my assumption is that Ryan Reynolds said, you know what, I'll walk if you don't want me to have creative freedom with this character who I made famous in the film. And rightfully so, I think he deserves some creative freedom with the character. And Feige was like, all right, walk, because we're not giving you 100%. And then other people at Disney were like, look, we gotta meet somewhere in the middle. Which is why you're going to have Ryan Reynolds still as a producer on the film, because them two are going to work together and they're going to deliver something that doesn't go one way too much or another. I'm assuming Deadpool 3 is going to meet right there, right in the middle of being a MCU film and a Ryan Reynolds Deadpool film, which in my mind just goes back to, hey, it's going to be more like Deadpool 1, which, hell yeah. It's really going to be interesting to see how this happens, because I honestly think it's the best outcome possible, because one, Ryan Reynolds can be restrained and not go all out. Two, Disney can monitor both of them and tell them, hey guys, keep it in line, work together, we gotta all work for the benefit of this. And three, it lets Kevin Feige dictate how MCU characters will be used when Ryan Reynolds wants to use them, which honestly was my worst fear, if they let Ryan Reynolds have full creative control. Because the last thing I would want to do is see the Falcon Captain America show up and be like, oh man, we need some help. And Wade just goes, well, we could have help from Daredevil if Kevin Feige didn't give him to Netflix and he won't acknowledge Jeff Loeb's creations. Yeah, congrats to you, three people in the crowd that understood that deep nerd cut reference in the theater. Yay for you. Then there's the other part of the crowd going, there was a Daredevil TV show? What?